बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। आज हम जी पीएम फ्यूल सेल मॉडल उसको यहाँ उसकी मॉडलिंग मैटलैब पे करेंगे और उसकी सिमुलेशन करेंगे। लेकिन एक बात याद रखें, हम यहाँ पे फ्यूल सेल की केमिकल एनालिसिस नहीं करेंगे, बल्कि हम उसे कंट्रोल और एलिटिकल पर्सपेक्टिव व्यू से इसको मॉडल करेंगे और मैटलैब में इसकी सिमुलेशन करेंगे। सो टुडे लेट्स डिस्कस द मॉडलिंग ऑफ द फ्यूल सेल। हियर वी आर स्पेसिफिकली डिस्कसिंग द प्रोटॉन एक्सचेंज मेंबर इन फ्यूल सेल। द इक्विवेलेंट मॉडल इज शोन हियर इन द फिगर इज द पोटेंशियल डेवलप्ड बाय द सेल। दिस इज कैलकुलेटेड एज पर नर्नेस्ट लॉ। द वोल्टेज इज ऑल्सो वोल्टेज लॉस बाय द कंसेंट्रेशन लॉस ऑफ द रिएक्टेंस इज शोन बाय आर कन्वर्टर and the voltage loss due to the activation of anode and cathode is shown by RAC and the ohmic loss, the current ohmic loss is shown by R, a resistance, and the voltage developed by the single cell is VFC and single cell output current IFC. So this equations VFC gives the output voltage of this cell, single cell. Then it is Nernst voltage potential developed as per Nernst law, and the voltage loss due to activation of anode and cathode, ohmic loss, this is voltage drop due to ohmic loss, and V concentration, this is the voltage drop due to the concentration loss of the reactants. So let's model this PEM cell. So if n number of cells are connected, then the output should be multiplied by n. As per Nernst law, the output potential of the PEM cell can be calculated by this equation, and V activation loss voltage can be calculated by this equation, where the CO2 is the concentration of the oxygen and it can be calculated from this equation, where PO2 is the partial pressure of the oxygen during the reaction. V concentration loss can be calculated by this equation, and similarly V ohmic loss can be calculated by this equation, and the RM is the equivalent membrane resistance calculated by this equation. So all the abbreviations are given here. You can see it, ABC, CO2, and similarly voltage drop due to activation, and all of the abbreviations are here discussed in detail. The typical values of the parameters are given in this table, and these typical values are calculated by the inherent optimization algorithm, and there are four inputs of this fuel cell model. The temperature, so it's separated at 5 centigrade, partial temperature of the hydrogen reactant is 0.1, and oxygen pressure is 1 atmospheric. Total 70 cells are used in series, and the area of the cell is 69.4. At the output of this PEM cell, boost converter is connected. The transfer function of this boost converter is given by this equation, and this equation, this transfer function will help us to tune the PID controller. So if we discuss the overall model of developing this simulation, you can see here at the output of the PEM cell, the boost converter is connected and a closed loop PID controller is used. sensing its output voltage, a reference voltage of 100 voltage, and PID controller is regulating the output voltage 100 volt. And to tune the PID controller, this transfunction will help us. जैसा कि हमने पहले भी स्टडी किया, हमने इसको मैट लैब में अब इंप्लीमेंट करना है. और ये हमारे पास पीएम फ्यूल सेल है, ये हमारे पास बूस्ट कन्वर्टर है, और ये पीआईडी कंट्रोलर क्लोज लूप में हम आउटपुट वोल्टेज को 100 वोल्ट पे रेगुलेट कर रहे हैं. अगर हम पीएम फ्यूल सेल की बात करते हैं तो फ्यूल सेल का जो वोल्टेज है, हमने वो जो फॉलोइंग इक्वेशंस यहाँ वो यहाँ पे हमने मैटलैब में इंप्लीमेंट किए, और इसको हम वोल्टेज कंट्रोल एक सोर्स हमने यहाँ पे मैटलैब से लिया, जिसको इनपुट कंट्रोल वोल्टेज सोर्स. और आफ्टर कैलकुलेटिंग द वोल्टेज फ्रॉम दोज इक्वेशंस, आउटपुट इज गिवन एज इनपुट टू दिस वोल्टेज सोर्स एंड दिस एक्टिंग एज पीएम फ्यूल सेल. So how those equations are implemented? We are discussing that we have four inputs: the temperature 328 Kelvin, 0.1 atmospheric hydrogen partial pressure, and oxygen one is 1 atmospheric. Area 69.4. One thing that we have used. The current of the fuel cell, this is that's used in the fuel cell modeling. So how we have implemented this, you can see here the nearest equation is implemented here. Area and all the parameters are given here. Activation loss voltage is calculated here. Similarly, Ohmic voltage are calculated here. Concentration loss are calculated here, and activation voltage loss is calculated here. And the output can be calculated. Next, activation voltage drop, concentration voltage loss, and Ohmic voltage loss are calculated, and the final output calculated in this block. You can see here the output VFC is equal to NMS minus Ohmic loss, concentration loss, and activation loss. And here is it's multiplied by 70 because we are using 70 cells. So let's go for simulation. After simulation, you can see the results. The output voltage of fuel cell and current. This one, the voltage, output voltage of fuel cell, and having 70 cells in series, and this is the output current of the fuel cell. So you here, you can see that it's almost 92.7. And the current is almost 45.8 ampere. And you are not seeing here any transient because we are not modeled here in this equation capacitor. The capacitor should be included if you want to transients and behavior of that fuel cell. So here we are only considering the steady state value. Similarly, the output voltage you can see here are regulated at 100 volt, and the input voltage as previous seen was 91.7, 91.6. Output current is almost 10 ampere, and this output voltage is dependent on this load resistance, that's 10 ohm. If you want to see the dynamic response along with the steady state response, then you should also incorporate this derivative equation because in our case we have ignored this capacitor, we have ignored this capacitor because we are only interested in the steady state response of that PN fuel cell. So implement this capacitor, this derivative equation, and you will also will be able to, so by solving this derivative equation you will be able to see the dynamic response of the equation. This one all about PM fuel cell modulus simulation. Kindly subscribe our channel, हमारे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कीजिए ताकि आप मज़ीद कंट्रोल और माइक्रोवेव के इससे रिलेटेड जो भी वीडियोज़ और जो कंट्रोल मॉडलिंग वो आप देख सकें. शुक्रिया.